The Crickets are back. With all the nostalgia love over the 1980s pouring over us last few years, I guess it was only a matter of time before someone would dust off the awesome sci-fi franchise, Critters. First we got a TV show called Critters on new binge for Shudder, and now I can present to you a new full feature film, simply called Critters Attack. While this is the fifth film in the franchise, it is not clear if this is a sequel or a reboot. We do have Dee Wallace return to it, for a few minutes at least, but she does not seem to play the same character that she did back in the original. And honestly, there was no need to have her in it when they hardly even used her. Critters Attack sees the Space Crickets return to Earth and a new small town where they are on the hunt for someone special, a white striped Crickets who are injured and in hiding. It is found by a group of young teens who try to heal and take care of it, which at the same time makes them a target for these bloodthirsty, hairy spaceballs. While they are trying to find help, the Crickets start to take over and cause havoc in their small town, eating everything and everyone who gets in their way. So this is not the big return of Critters that some fans might have hoped for. This feels like a test by Warner to see what type of interest there is out there for a new Critters film, and it looks like they went a safe way about it. The production is obviously low budget, and it is scheduled to be shown on the Sci-Fi channel, which feels like a good home for it, and I guess that should tell you something about what level of excitement you should keep yourself at. But just because something is low budget and made for the Sci-Fi channel, doesn't mean it has to be bad. I have enjoyed several of Sci-Fi originals, and you could argue that there isn't a need for a multi-million dollar budget to tell the story of the Critters. So how is Critters Attack? Well, it's uneven. It was awesome to see the Critters in action again, as I have a huge love for this franchise. Critters 2 was one of the first films I had on VHS as a kid, and I rewatched that over and over again while growing up. I'm happy to see that the Crickets are still alive and kicking with practical effects, for most parts, and I become happy whenever I see them on screen. I was a bit surprised at how big they were in size this time around though, but I guess it made it easier to film them. Maybe it's nitpicking or nostalgia, but I prefer the smaller version of Critters. They do get plenty of screen time and plenty of human snacks to devour, so if a movie with Critters, well, attacking, is enough to make you want to spend your time with this film, then I think you'll be satisfied. The bad part of the film is that it tries to be funny with comedic dialogue that just seemed to miss and miss for me. It is not a well-written movie, and it feels like it was thrown together quite quickly. The same can be said about the characters, as the young actors do seem to try their best, but they just don't get a lot to work with, and the little character traits they get seem to get lost or fail to pay off. There also isn't that much of a scope to the story. The climax takes place at a college, but while there are some people around, it still feels too empty. And while there is a lot of running from the Crickets and eating being displayed, the film still feels a bit slow and frankly, cheap. Like it is lacking any type of urgency, perhaps due to them wanting this to be a campy fun film, and it might not have been sticking out so much if the comedy had worked. I was surprised to find out that the screenplay was written by Scott Lobdell, the guy who wrote the clever and fun Happy Death Day. I just gotta assume that he had more ideas for this than what the final product showed, or that he only had a few days to finish this, as everything written for Critters Attack is miles away from the good stuff we got with Happy Death Day. I will say that I did enjoy the synth music that was created for the film. It stood out from the otherwise more generic music that was used for the majority of the film, and while the only music credit is for Russ Howard III, the difference in quality for the synth stuff and the rest makes me wonder if he did all of it or only the synth, while the rest was stock music. I haven't seen the TV show Critters A New Binge, so I can't compare these two, but I will say that Critters Attack is for the hardcore fans of Critters only. It is not a good film, by far, as it at times is even sloppy, but the critter action itself will be enough for some of us to have a good time with this. So if you are good with the idea of a sci-fi version of Critters, then sure, pick up Critters Attack and give it a go, just don't go into it expecting too much. the big return of critters will have to wait, as Critters Attack only gets the OK score of 2.5 out of 5. Have you been able to check out Critters Attack yet? And what do you think of the Critters series in general? Should I check out Critters on your binge? Leave all your critteristic ideas in the comment section below. Another small creatures kill people movie that I've done a review of and that more people definitively need to check out is a little film from 1993 called Little Devils The Birth. So check that review out as well if this is the kind of stuff that you enjoy. That's it for me, I hope you enjoyed this video, please do leave a like if that's the case, and thank you for spending your time on this dark corner of YouTube called Cinema Terror.